In this video, we're going to create a repeating sequence of numbers, and we'll do this with a formula, and we'll do this in a way that works both in Excel and Google Sheets. First of all, let's just understand what exactly we're trying to do. So there are two types of repeating sequences you may possibly have. One is, let's say you have like 1, 2, 3, 4, and then that same sequence repeats over and over and over like this. Or you could want something like this. And in this case, basically this repeats like 4 times, then this repeats 4 times, and then this repeats 4 times. And so it goes. And maybe that sequence is not 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe you want to do like 0, 5, 10, 15, and 20, and then it should basically repeat again. So I'm going to get rid of all of this and let's try to create this repeating sequence of numbers. So first we're gonna use a function called sequence. So sequence function, it's gonna ask you for number of rows. So basically if I do 5, the rest of these arguments are optional. So right now, if I just close parentheses, hit enter, it will basically create one column of numbers with 5 rows, and it starts from 1, and it's gonna basically just increase 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, if I go back to this and add a comma, the second optional argument is columns. And for this, if I do, let's say, 2 columns, see, now we got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So now we get 5 rows and 2 columns of these numbers. I'm going to go back and change this to just 1 column. And then that's just 5 rows and 1 column, which is this. Now, if I go back to that same formula, the next argument, if I do a comma, is starting point. So if you don't want to start from, let's say, 1, you want to start from 5 or 0 or whatever the number may be. So for example, I'll do a 5. So now it's going to start from 5 and it's going to go 6, 7, 8, 9. And that's how this is going to go. And then finally, the last argument here is called step. And this controls the increment between these numbers. So for example, if I do 2, instead of going 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, it's going to go 5 and then go up by 2, 7, and then 9, and then 11. So for example, if I want to start at 1, I would do start 1. And then if I want to go 1, 3, 5, 7, that would be step 2. There it is, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So for now, I'll just go back to just this. So it's just 5 numbers starting from 1. It goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now we need to create this sequence and then repeat the sequence. So let's say we want to then do another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 again, something like that. What I'm going to do here, I'm going to just leave this alone and I'm going to create another sequence function. And for this one, I'm going to generate 1 row of numbers, but instead of doing 1 column now, I'm going to do multiple columns. So let's do, for example, 4 columns. So if I do this, hit enter, it's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 now in this direction. Now in this case, I don't want this to increase. I want this to basically stay the same number. I want this to be 1, 1, 1, and 1, 4 times. So I'm going to go back here and go after this and do a comma. And as a starting point, I'm going to start at 1. And as a step, which is how much we increase between the first and second number, I'm going to do a 0, which means don't increase. And as a result, I get 1, 1, 1, 1. So 4 ones. So now I got this list of numbers and this list of numbers. So if we have 2 lists of numbers like this, and we simply just take this list of numbers and multiply it by this list of numbers, what's going to happen if I hit enter, because this is in a list of columns and this is in a row, what basically ends up happening, we're gonna get like 1 times 1, this is this, then 1 times 1 again, which is this, and so it goes for all of these, and then 2 times 1, 2 times 1, which is all of these 2s. And then we get this list, like so. Now, instead of using this, I'm just going to use the functions here. So instead of this, I'll just go here, grab this sequence function, copy and paste this right here, which should be the same list. And then this sequence function, we'll just copy and paste here. So as a result, basically we multiply this 2 sequence functions together. And basically now I don't really need these. And the reason I did those to explain you how this entire thing works. Now I'm gonna put all of these numbers to a single column by using a function called 2col, 2column. I'm gonna open parentheses and gonna close parentheses after this whole thing. And that will basically just take this whole bunch of numbers and put all of them in a single column. And you're gonna see what happens now. We go like 4 ones, and then 4 twos, and then 3s, and then 4s, and then 5s. So basically we end up repeating this 4 times for each number here. So if I didn't want to do like 4 times, I can change this 4 to 3. And then we got 3 ones, 3 twos, 3 threes, 3 fours, 3 fives. So that's that. So that's what 2 column does by default. So if I just take this 2 column function out of here for a second. So essentially what it's doing, when you do 2 column, it goes like this. And then this, and then this. So by default, it goes row by row and converts each row to a column. And that's the results you get. Now, you also have the option to go like this instead of going like this. And the way you can do that, if you just go here and do 2col, 2col, go after this whole thing and add a comma, here it's going to ask you if you want to keep all values or ignore blanks or errors. We don't have any blanks or errors, so this really doesn't make any difference for us. So I'm just gonna skip this argument, comma. And then finally, the last argument is, do we wanna go by row or by column? So if I switch this by column, which is this, close parentheses, hit enter. See, now what happens, instead of getting 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4, we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 again, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3 times. And the way we control here number of times this repeats is by this, 3 times. So if I change this 3 to 5, let me just zoom out a little bit. You're gonna see it's 1, 2, 3, 4, and finally 5 times. So now I can repeat this as many times as I want by changing this variable right here, 5. Now the other one, this sequence, that sequence we control with this first sequence function. So if I don't want this to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I want this to be, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, then I will change this to 4. And that goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and it's still gonna repeat that 5 times based on this second sequence function. Now, finally, if you don't want this to be 1, 2, 3, 4, let's say you want this to be 0, 5, 10, 15. This is where you can change this first sequence function. I can add a comma, and for number of columns, I'm gonna do 1, comma, and as a start, I'm gonna go 0, comma, and then the step, I'm gonna go 5. So basically, it's gonna go 0, 5, 10. So if I hit enter, you're gonna see 0, 5, 10, 15, and then 0, 5, 10, 15. So now we get that sequence of numbers, 0, 5, 10, 15, and it's gonna repeat this many times. So if I do 5 times, it's gonna do 5 times. If I go 20 times, it's gonna go 20 times. If I do 2 times, it's just gonna repeat that twice. Apparently I didn't do 2 times, I did something else, I did 3. Let's do actually 2. And there it is, 2 times. 2 times, and this is the sequence that we basically repeat. Finally, that's 2 times. We can go back here and update this. Now, if I don't want this to be starting from 0, let's say I want to start from 1, and I want to go step 2, like 1, 3, 5, I'll do this. 1357. Here, I'll just keep it simple. I'll just go step one, which you could just also just leave blank. It would get you the same thing. So it goes 1234, and then it's going to keep repeating. If you don't want 1234, you want to go 1234567. You change this to 6. So that's 6 rows of data, 1234567, and it's going to repeat twice because we have 2 here. If we go 4, it's going to repeat 4 times. And that's pretty much the whole logic behind this formula. Now, in Google Sheets, it's going to be the same formula, except that it needs to basically understand that this is an array. So if I just copy this formula exactly the way it is, and we open a Google Sheets spreadsheet and we just paste it here. If I just hit enter, you'll see I don't really get the same results because Google Sheets doesn't automatically handle dynamic arrays like Excel does. You need to explain this formula that this actually is an array formula. And for that, we're going to do Control Shift Enter or Command Shift Enter. And basically what that's going to do, it's going to add this array formula function around this whole thing to explain this formula that this is an array formula. And as a result, now if I enter, I'm going to be getting the same exact results we would get in Excel. And that's how we create a repeating sequence of numbers. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.